So the paste in principle for the strips is obviously the same. We want to keep it nice and neat when we're pasting. Everything's finished in squares. One square finished onto next square. However, the folding principle at this stage is slightly different. What we're going to do is we're going to turn this now into an envelope fold. Keep it as level as you can. Drop it back down, remembering just to slide it across. Open hands, just pull it across. All we want is nice, that's straight and that's straight. As long as those two edges are matching. Now, the reason for that is if this is going to start drying, we don't want a little edge because it'll dry very quickly. So, we're going to pull this now to the end of the board. Finish pasting it. Remember, this hand is the one what does the work. Got quite a new brush here. I'm being spoilt with a new brush. Now, the one problem with a new brush, and the reason I did want to use a new brush, is because you'll find that you do get bristles coming out of them. And luckily, it has happened, because as I was working with it, it wasn't happening. Now, I just wanted you to show that it does happen with the new brush, and it's just easy enough just to take them off. You will find throughout the videos what we're doing, or the DVDs what we're doing, that we will be looking to overcome any problems, and we will try and invent those problems to make sure people see how to get past the problems, because not everything goes straightforward all the time. And if you're on somebody's house, especially if it's a customer, you need to know how to get past that problem. Right, same again now. We're going to pick up the corner and fold it into a... This is called an envelope fold. We're going to get it as close as we can to that fold. Right, once we've got it on the board at that stage, we get his tape measure. And we're going to measure the strip. So we're going to go across now and measure the strip itself. Right, this is a strip what we're left with. Now, it could be that it's going to be bigger or shorter at one side. So don't take it for granted that this strip is going to be the same. It'd be fantastic if it was always going to be spot on. We're going to measure it. We've got 10 centimetres. Now, I'm still getting used to the new money. 4 inches, 10 centimetres. A lot of the old tradesmen still work in inches. A lot of the new tradesmen coming through work in centimetres. Joiners tend to work in centimetres and millimetres. So there's still that discrepancy. I'm going to measure it again in the middle, and I'm going to measure it at that end. The reason is if it's out, I need to know. We're now on 11.5 centimetres. If I'd have cut this strip at 10 centimetres, I would have been 1.5 centimetres short here. So we now know that this strip's going to have to be cut. If you can get an exact measurement, it's brilliant. You can do all your work on your board and just slide it straight on. We can't at this stage, and it's very rare that happens. So, and as last one, is 12 centimetres. So, I looked at that, and I'm just looking at that corner then, and it goes back down to 11 again. So it goes from 10, 11.5, 12, back down to 11. So I'm going to have to cut this now, or we're going to have to cut this length now. We want enough to cut that strip. We don't want to be struggling on a little piece like this. So if we're saying that's going to be 12 centimetres, if we put 1 centimetre on, that should be sufficient for us. We're going to cut that strip at 14 centimetres. Now, a good practice, if you're nothing like me, it's so easy to forget what that measurement is. Write it on wall. Yeah, 14 centimetres. If I'm at my pasteboard and I've forgot what it is, I'll look at that wall, I know it's 14 centimetres. It's just a little tip, but it works for me. It might not work for you. You might have a very good memory. Great. So that's that. Now we'll go and cut this strip.
Right, a strip is folded in the format of an envelope as tape measure. Right, we've said 14 centimetres. Now, you'll see a lot of this, 14 centimetres. I'm doing something drastically wrong here. If I start trying to measure like this, I've got a lot of play and I'm not going to get it accurate. We're going for good practice now. We want to do it with all this paper, it's same. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this round. If I press my thumb onto that, that will come off straight. If I hold it reasonably tight with my thumb on it, that is now straight. So when I now mark my 14 centimetres, I've got a straight edge. Yeah? I'm going to mark it a few times. I'm not just going to mark it once. I'm going to mark it a few times. Yeah? So on, press, finger down. If that's straight, that's straight. Now, that's the difference between that and that. I'm going to measure a few times, 14 centimetres. Yeah. Now, that's gone. Not a problem at this stage. The other point sorted. Usually, if the pencils are breaking, it's because they've been dropped on floor a few times. And what happens is if you drop them on floor, the lead inside, it breaks. And that's why, as I say, it's always good. Keep that pencil sharpened at both sides. You're not stopping when you need it most. So, I've got myself my little spots. I'm going to go back to my straight edge. Or a spirit level can be used at this stage if you want to use a spirit level. I'm going to put my line on my straight edge. And I'm going to put my line on. So this is now our strip. Yeah, and I'm going down with my line. Straightforward at this stage, or it seems straightforward. As long as I line up to those lines. Bear in mind this is getting cut off as well, so we're not 100% worried about this one. Now, there's two things I can do now. I can either use scissors, or I can use straight edge. For speed, I would use a straight edge. Put it down here, straight down my strip. Now, if I was going to use the straight edge, I wouldn't have put the pencil line on. But, pull it. Now, remember when I'm pulling, it tears downwards, not upwards. Yeah? So, up and along. It's quite quick if you're going to use this method, but I do suggest you practice it first. Don't just go into something until you've practiced it. I know it looks good on sight and people look good when they're doing it, but your tried and tested method is always going to be your scissors. Because if all else fails, scissors come out. They're only ever going to cut to point. So as long as you've got that point, pointed across that line, it's going to cut to it. Yeah. So what we've got now is a cut length, a little bit further. Yeah, right. If we can use that up, we will use that up. Now, it depends how much you use and how much you don't. Some people will open that out and spread it across something to reuse it at a later stage when it's dried. But if you've got somewhere to use it, we will use it up. We could also splice, but we will cover that at a later stage. At the moment, we're interested in his diplomas in painting and decorating in college. We're setting these lessons up for people who's been unable to make the demonstration. So when they're coming in for it, if they've not been able to make the demonstration, they can see what they've missed and recap on it. However, at this stage, I would like just to suggest that it's easy for us if somebody's there to be able to put it right or try to put it right. It's not always easy from a video watching it and trying to do it yourself. So if you can make that lesson practically hands-on, it's by far the easiest way to learn. If you can't make that lesson, then watch the video, see what you've missed, and let's see how we can catch it up. Now, we've got a strip, and what we're going to do now is we're going to turn it back into a corsetina fold so we can take it across the wall. Now, straight away, into the Costantina fold again. We don't want big folds. If we've got big clumsy folds, we look clumsy when we go on tuck wall. We want a nice, easy, relaxed fold size. So as you can see, I mean, for me, that's your nice fold size. If you was putting a border on the wall, this is your same principle. Yeah, nice little folds, straightforward. The border would go on exactly the same as what we're going to put this strip on. Yeah, and at the end, fold it over and we'll go and put this strip on. Right, we're back in the room with a strip. All we're going to do, same again, two folds, no more. Offer the strip up. Now, this strip's slightly small. It's too small for the brush sometimes. If that's the case, don't panic. You don't necessarily want to be using a big brush on a strip that size, because if you do, it can become quite clumsy. You have to work to the side like that and keep it going. So what we tend to do is use your cloth. Remember, it's on my shoulder. Yeah, I'm going to get a wet shoulder, I know that, you know that. And all I'm going to do is run it down using... Now, remember, when we measured it, we got 10 centimetres at that side. And as you can see, it's now getting smaller. We need to make it big enough to fit, but we also want enough on there to cut it off. If we've got an exact measurement, it's brilliant. We can cut it to the exact size and put it straight on while we have any cutting. And it works quite well, but it's very, very rare that happens. If it does happen, be grateful. It's not going to happen often. Yeah. And each time, I'm just leaving enough space for myself, making sure we've got enough to cut off, and we're flattening it down. Now, at this stage, we're going to come to the corner. Right, interesting. The first cut in this corner with the scissors is a quick cut into the corner. I'll do that before I put my pencil down. So you're asking, why have I done that before I've put my pencil down? If I don't do that before I put my pencil down, we end up with that ripping. And we don't want the rip. So I've put that little nick in, and that saved me any discomfort when I come to that corner. Right. I'm going to work my way down this, and as I'm going down, I'm just going to stick my fingernails into it. I'm going to make sure my fingernails are right into the bottom edge. Yeah, with a little bit of paper, it takes me seconds to get it in my pouch. It doesn't have to be on the floor. Yeah, same again. 45 degrees into the corner. You can see corner. You don't need to struggle with it. It will only ever cut to where the point of them scissors goes. Yeah. And then I'm going to put my pencil down, remembering I'm going to put it the pencil line on the wall I'm cutting out to, and not the wall I'm papering. Yeah. Now we've got quite a big strip here. You're going to ask yourself the question now, do I want to go down this wall? The way to do it is to go down with a pencil. Mark your pencil line. Out come your scissors. Pull it off the wall. And cut it off. However, under the circumstances, we have got a different option. Now, some papers I don't want you thinking that this is the way forward every time. We're going to use a straight edge. We're also going to use a clip-off knife. Practice this before you do it a lot. Now, what we don't want at this stage is people, very sharp blades, very clinical cuts. Can be very awkward. When you've got these out, you don't want them out like that. You only want them out one blade at a time. Because one, it's very flexible. And two, if you are going to get cut, they're going very quickly and it's a very clinical cut. Trust me, they do take a lot of stopping bleeding. We're going to put on the straight edge and we're going to cut along the line. Yeah, like that. Now, I'm going to leave that paper there for the minute. I don't want to be chasing it down wall. So I'm going to put that on and I'm going to cut the line. Yes, you can do this to skirting boards. You can do it to ceilings. It doesn't work with every paper. Try the paper first because sometimes it'll ruffle up. If you haven't got your blade sharp enough, it'll ruffle up. But if you're on site, yes, it's quicker than going down with scissors. And it's a clinical edge. Very tidy, very neat. When we get onto us pattern papers, going round plug sockets, you'll see at this stage they come into their own. However, saying that, we are going to cover the plug socket in a minute with these little knives. There's one little thing I do want to explain to you. We've had quite a lot of incidences lately where people have been going around the plug socket with the knives and the blade has been going down the back of the top edge of these plug sockets here. Now, what happens is the electricians will come to a plug socket. All the wires are at the back of here. Now, we always turn them plug sockets off. But what happens is because that's such a fine blade, always if you're going around a plug socket, keep it to the bare minimum. The minute that goes down the back of there, you're in danger of cutting them wires. Always remember, and there is a live wire at the back of there. If that switches off, there's always a live feed at the back of there. So once that goes down the back of there and cuts that wire, and the way the electricians put them on, they haven't got a lot of space. So all the wires are pushed up at the back of here. You catch it with your knife, you've got problems. So just bear that in mind. And we will, when we come to the pattern papers and further on into the qualification, show you how that's done. So, as you can see now, I've cut that. I haven't took it off at that stage. Why haven't I took it off? I don't want it all over the floor. This is where I'm going to take it off now. And I'm going to fetch it back down wall with me. Yeah. Yes, it's cut. I know it's cut. But I don't want long, scraggy pieces of paper all over the floor for me to fall on. I'm not bothered about other people so much, but myself. Yeah, keeping it clean and tidy all the time. That's the secret. Well, if we're clean and tidy, people are going to have us back on their houses. If we're not clean and tidy, people, purely and simply, they don't want somebody who's messy on their house. That strip is in my pouch. It's not on the floor. It's not on somebody's carpet. It's not on dust sheet. That's a strip completed.